can find the COM port settings in the Panel Manager, which you can access either here from the Setup menu, Panel Manager, or in a Navigation Windows Function tab, Panel Manager. This is the Seymour Micrographic panel, and these are the COM ports on that panel. This is the device that we want to hook to our Seymour Micrographic panel through one of these COM ports. Here's a helpful hint. You can right-click on the device and change its name to something that makes more sense to you. We're using a Click PLC here, so let's change this to Click 1. For this demo, the Click PLC is connected to COM port 1, not COM port 2. So to change that, we just click on the device and change it to COM port 1. There's a wide variety of PLC protocols you can choose from that will meet the needs of most PLCs on the market today. When you pick a PLC protocol, we'll pick the Click PLC that we're connected to. Most of the parameters will be filled in for you. Just double check that the parameters match those of the PLC project you're connecting to. Make sure that the PLC slave number matches that of your PLC project, otherwise the panel won't talk to your PLC. Double check that all your parameters are correct. If you have any questions on any of these parameters, check out the help file. There's detailed explanations for all of these. If all of this looks correct and you're still getting COM errors, check out the how-to video on debugging COM errors for a list of things you can try. Well, that's all there is to setting up the COM port. Be sure to check out the other videos in this series. And as always, please send us any topics you would like to see covered, or any other comments for that matter. We appreciate the feedback.